ATL Review Show Round 2. We are live from the Mackay Mid North Open today. We've got the my guest host this week is the latest sensation CNCL, Matt Wycross. Matt, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Sam.
So this week we're going to review last week's ties at Kalinda Chase and preview the tie at West in a couple of weeks' time. So let's start with last week's match. The home team, Kalinda Cavaliers, beating Mackay Magic 6-4, some unbelievable tennis. Matt, talk us through the men's doubles.
Yeah, it was a good battle. We came out strong early in the first set, and they came back at us, and we ended up playing a super tiebreak, and just played in good spirit and good intensity all the way through, and yeah, it was good to get the win.
And let's go through your men's singles match with James Rodgers. You seemed pretty pumped up for that one.
I was. After the doubles, we had a lot of intensity and a lot of energy going on, and took it straight into the singles and tried to keep it going, and James slowed things up a bit, and tried to change the tempo of the match, and it ended up being a really good battle in the end, and I really enjoyed it. So it's good to go up the first two matches with the men. The girls did quite back to start. They had a tough battle against Tanika and Little Miss Rogers there, but yeah, it was good to be 2-2 after the first four.
So 3-3 going into mixed. Did your manager Lefty have some wise words for you?
No, he sat back and had his normal smoke and coke out the back there while he was watching. That was not a lot of team spirit from Lefty, but he's one of the kind.
Bit of a different management style there. So let's move on to talk about the Barras versus the Heat. The Barras too hot to handle, winning 8-2. The Heat can take some comfort from a mixed doubles win and a singles win, so they'll be looking to build on that in the next round. Let's talk about the Townsville Thunder, probably the result of the night, beating West Magpies 6-4. Jared Winterthorne outboxing Brad and Taylor in that one. Thoughts on that one, Matt?
Well, I didn't get to see much of the match, but going into it, I would have thought that the Magpies would be too strong there, so they've done very well to get over the top of Brad and Taylor in that one, and well done. They're looking like a very solid team who might challenge for the top two spots in the comp this year, so well done to them.
So we're going to look now at the league table. The Cavs bearing down on the final. They should make that barring some sort of disaster. It's really all about the Thunder and the Magic trying to make it into that second spot for the grand final. So there's going to be a huge tie coming up there. The loser probably gets into the third or fourth place with the Barras. And the Heat and Magpies probably need a couple of big wins to jag their way into the third and fourth place playoffs. All right, so let's look ahead now to the next tie at West on Saturday 18th. First matchup, the Magpies versus the Barras. Magpies looking for their first win. They're going to be minus Brad and Taylor, and the Barras are going to be plus Jack and Adam Walton, so I'm looking forward to a bit of a rest in that one. How do you see that one going, man?
Without Brad and Taylor there, and plus the Waltons, I think the Barras will be far too strong now. I'd say probably an 8-2 to behind the Barras there. They look too strong on paper, so
8-2. And the Heat will be looking for their first win against the Cavs. Cavs dominating the competition so far. David Singer's probably going to step up on that one, do you think?
He does. Hopefully he'll be fit and ready to go and can put up a good fight and give the Cavs another challenge. I think if all the teams can stand up and match their spirit and match their play, then it really helps lift the competition as a whole. So
let's look at probably the key tie of the round, the Mackay Magic versus the Townsville Thunder. Crucial this one to see who gets into that grand final. Minus Matt Wycross.
That's right.
What's going on there?
I'm actually down the Sunshine Coast for my brother-in-law's 40th birthday, so the tie calls are a bad time for me. And hopefully the team can get some players together and put up a fight against the Thunder. Really love to be playing on the first and second this year, but taking it to the stage.
And who's going to be taking your place?
Nathan Gardner will be in the team. Hopefully Harry Wright will be there as well. And hopefully Sam Noyika can take a bit of a lead role with the girls and bring home a victory for us. It'll be a tough game.
All right, so we look forward to those rounds and matches at West on Saturday 18th. We'll see you there at 6 p.m. Matt, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks, Sam.
And guys, have a great Easter, and we'll see you soon.